be round. My vegetables I'm gonna chow down. My vegetables I love you most of all. My favorite vegetable. If you brought a big brown bag of them home, I'd jump up and down and hope you'd toss me a carrot. I'm gonna keep well my vegetables card off and sell. My vegetables I love you most of all. My favorite vegetable.
Good morning, Eagle Nation. It's Monday yet again. It is May the 10th. It is the 168th day of school. It's 8:31 a.m. Office Standard Time. Wherever you may be, please stop, please stand, and let us rise for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. Hope you're dressed for success. We've got a lot of stuff going on, so listen up close. First of all, that was the song My Vegetables by the Beach Boys, the one and only. It was a song dedication from Dr. Music. Thank you, Dr. Music. She dedicates that song to Elma and the cafeteria staff for serving us so many breakfasts, lunches, and snacks with love. As a side note, it is also Miss Elma's birthday today. So happy birthday, Miss Elma, and thank you to all of our child nutrition staff. In addition to that, what's going on this week? We are celebrating May is Asian Pacific Heritage Month. We even missed the first week of that, but as Maya Angelou says, and even our own, very own Miss Ramos, know better, do better. And so when these things come to mind, we should do better, and so we will. We can't fix what we didn't do in the past because we didn't do a great job in September in celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month. We didn't do a great job as a school site of celebrating Native American Heritage Month. So we must do better, and we will. This month, we will celebrate Asian American and Asian Pacific Heritage Month, and we've featured for you on our Google site below a famous mathematician because it's also Mathematical Monday. So today we celebrate mathematician Dr. Fan Chung. She is a mathematician, a professor, an author, and a mother. She formerly worked at Bell Telephone Company, but what she's most notable for, at least most interesting from our perspective perhaps, was that she explored this question. Can you hear the shape of a graph? Can you hear the shape of a graph? Think about that for a moment. You, from kindergarten through eighth grade, study all kinds of graphs, from tally charts to bar charts, histograms, and of course, linear graphs. But can you hear them? Read more about Dr. Chung to find out what she discovered in her study of mathematics. And thank you, Dr. Chung, for your contribution to us today. In addition to that, we continue with our celebration of PBIS. This week, we are focused on being caring. And on this Monday, here's our tip for you. Use kind words today. We are almost at the end of the year, and it's getting hot. Kindness will continue. We hope that you do your part, and we know that you will. Let's see. Also, this week, while last week we celebrated our teachers, this week we celebrate our Emerson support staff, and there's a lot of them. Listen in close to see if you recognize any of our favorite support staff for all they have done for us. We have our social worker, Ms. Bernadette DeGay. Her week was actually March 7th through 13th, but we were on spring break, and then we came back, and all of this happened all at once, and we missed our opportunity to celebrate her. School psychologist, Mr. Pucci. National School Psychology Week was actually back in November. We didn't know, and we didn't celebrate him, but we're grateful for all he has done and continues to do. Our instructional assistants, Mr. Mike Romo, Ms. Roxana Martinez, Ms. Kathy Brown, Ms. Anna Santos, Ms. Noemi Ramirez, Mr. Marco Santos, Mr. Ian Henry, Mr. Victor Cruz, Ms. Violet Phillips, Ms. Aurelia Munoz, Ms. Diana Garcia, Ms. Jasmine Haley, Ms. Maria Smith, and Ms. Ava Flores. We are grateful for all our instructional assistants do. Our custodians, Ms. Lily Fonseca, our lead custodian, as well as Mr. Austin Nunn and Ms. Maria Colson. Thank you. To our crossing guard, Ms. Laura Valdenegro, good morning and thank you. And to our permanent building subs, who we could not have done this with since March, Ms. Kim Carnegie, Mr. Gary Schiffman, and Ms. Kay Matthews. Thank you for being at Emerson and supporting us in all our efforts. These individuals have been online, in person. They've been at the learning labs. They've done home visits. They've hosted appointment-based services. They've cleaned our school, moved furniture to homes and back. They've disinfected our workspaces. They organized Eagle Store items. They worked one-on-one with students, hosted student clubs like Student Council, No Place for Hate, and Team Court. They've cleaned up messes, run errands, covered lunches. They've covered your preps and your duties. They've provided safe street crossing. They've taught walk-to-read sessions, answered phone calls in the office. They've subbed in classrooms, and so much more. It is these heroes that give our school capacity and make our school flexible on a day-to-day basis. With them, our school is safer, cleaner, calmer, and more predictable for all of us, students and families and staff. This week, we tip our hats to them. If you see them, take a moment to express your gratitude. If you'd like to jam on any of them, please use the Jamboard buttons below the morning announcements. Perhaps it's a great activity to do as part of your community circle in the morning, teachers. No words of gratitude are ever spent in vain. Thank you to Emerson support staff. We will celebrate them more formally on Wednesday of this week, and we have some treats coming your way to show how much we care and how much we couldn't do this job without you. We do appreciate you. Thank you. With that, let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. Today is on the golden rule, honesty and respect. Everybody loves the Muppets. Which one is your favorite? Is it Kermit the Frog? What about Big Bird or Cookie Monster?
No.
The man who created the Muppets was named Jim Henson. He was a very successful man, and those who knew him said that he trusted people to be fair and honest with him. And in return, he was fair and honest with them. He told the truth and expected others to tell the truth. He treated others with respect and expected others to treat him with respect. Jim Henson treated others the way he wanted to be treated. That sounds like the golden rule, doesn't it? You too. Today, let's remember this good man who brought so much joy into the world and always treat others the way we would want to be treated. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.
Oh, table pleasure and joy. I tried to kick the ball, but...